Just a robot.
It ain't easy being Lacey Green. That was my Kermit the Frog impression. Terrible, I know. Today I'm gonna do a commentary on one of Lacey Green's videos. Now, a whole lot of people have talked about this video, and I was tempted to jump on the bandwagon when it was going on, but I wanted to wait, mainly because her video had a lot to do with a Toby Turner rape allegation that was still going on at the time, and I wanted to wait for it to die down a bit before I talked about it, so we can all look at it with a clearer mind.
Hey, Internet! Question. Have you ever worried that someone was lying about rape?
Yes, I am afraid that someone might be lying about being raped. However, I am also afraid that they might be telling the truth and no one believes them. The thing about rape is it's a very hard thing to prove. Pretty much all people have to go off of is one word against another.
It's my word against yours.
Really, the only way we can be certain if someone was raped is if we put cameras everywhere, but that would be a breach of freedom. The only advice I can give to people who are raped is don't take a shower after being raped, mainly because you'll wash off all the evidence.
Every single time a woman comes forward about having been abused by a beloved movie star, musician, TV star, YouTubers, that star's fans immediately accuse her of lying.
Well, it's not always just their fans. There are many people who hate Tobuscus, yet they still called her a liar. Now, I myself am not really a fan of Tobuscus. I don't hate him, but I never really found his videos entertaining. Another thing is, Lacey, Tobuscus is really popular. I mean, really popular. And this girl was just a nobody, and she did this much damage to him with just a Tumblr post. Yes, it is true that a lot of people called her a liar without looking at the evidence. However, there were also many people who called Tobuscus a rapist without looking at the evidence.
There are men's groups online that claim that women lie about rape 90% of the time.
I've looked in your description. You have no links to any websites that say this. I also love how you said men's groups. Could you be any more vague? Now, I'm not saying there is no website that says that, but if there is, could you please provide evidence for it?
A sheriff in Idaho very recently claimed that they don't need a better system for rape kits which collect evidence because most victims are liars.
The majority of our rapes that are called in are actual consensual sex.
The thing is, rape kits can only detect when sex happened, not when rape happened. What a rape kit can do is take a series of swabs from the vagina, asshole, and mouth, then do a series of tests to find out if sex happened or not. However, it cannot detect if rape happened or not. Also, you're taking that officer out of context. Here's the context to what's going on.
I believe the legislature needs to take a strong look at allowing law enforcement to do their job and not try to dictate what we need to do. I think they're trying to help. I really do.
The proposed legislation would create a statewide system of collecting and tracking the physical evidence in a sexual assault case. Part of that bill would give clinics the responsibility of sending rape kits for DNA testing. That's unless the victim requests otherwise. Currently, law enforcement is in charge of deciding if a kit should be tested.
They need to let us decide if we're going to send the kit in and when we send the kits in. Because the majority of our rapes, not to say we don't have rapes, we do, but the majority of our rapes that are called in are actual consensual sex.
Roland says after interviewing an alleged rape victim, police often find it was not actually rape. Things just went too far and someone got scared.
It's a 17-year-old girl, and she had consensual sex with her boyfriend, but didn't know how to tell her parents. Or her parents are mad because she did have consensual sex, and well, you couldn't have said yes, you had to have been raped. What does that do to her down the road? What does it do to her partner?
And I mean, look, couldn't you or me or anybody in the world just make up a rape for attention to get revenge out of jealousy, as Toby Turner's mom posted on Facebook? Yeah, you could totally do that. But would you do that? And how often does that actually happen?
Lacey, you're playing into people's biases. Couldn't you or I rape someone? Yeah, you totally could. But would you do that? You see how that sounds? And there are many more reasons why someone would falsely accuse someone else of rape, such as mental illness, to hide infidelity, and there was even a case where a woman just dreamed about it.
The FBI states that between 2 and 8% of rape reports are false.
The 2 to 8% of rape allegations are false statistic is one of those bullshit feminist lies, like the wage gap or 1 in 5 women will be raped thing. The citation she puts up on screen, the Criminal Justice Information Services Division Uniform Crime Reports program, has absolutely nothing to do with the 2 to 8% statistic. Now, it has a little to do with rape, like what counts as rape. However, it has nothing to do with the 2 to 8% figure. Now, some of you are probably wondering, where did this 2 to 8% statistic come from? Well, it came from Susan Brown Miller's. She got the information from a judge who made a speech in front of a small crowd of lawyers, and his evidence for this was a small section of New York where female police officers were the only one conducting rape interviews. So in other words, this is not evidence. It's an anecdote on top of an anecdote on top of an anecdote. It's like anecdotal inception. Even if the evidence wasn't anecdotal, the sample size is much too small.
Which is actually a low number in the crime world. Other crimes, like, say, theft, they hover around 10% false reports. And even that 2 to 8% statistic is deceptive.
So the statistic is not bullshit enough, and you have to add even more bullshit on top of it.
It includes reports where someone accidentally identified the wrong person, reports that are thrown out because of inconsistent details, but it is a well-known fact amongst victimologists that trauma affects your memory.
That is true. 1 point for Lacey Green.
And that 2 to 8% includes survivors who recanted. Someone could take it back because they were lying, sure, but much more commonly, they take it back because they're being pressured to take it back.
Oh, bullshit.
Many of the reasons why we're inclined to doubt someone revolve around rape myths, myths about victims, and myths about gender. For one, most perpetrators aren't greasy, creepy guys who hang out in the shadows. They're just regular people in our lives. When fans, friends, family, coworkers find out that someone that they know and love did something terrible, it can be really hard to grapple with and accept, and instead, they choose to deny it.
While I do agree with some of the stuff you are saying, what about those people who are not friends, family, or fans, but still think they're innocent?
That halo effect around a perpetrator can be so strong that you can have cases like Cosby's where nearly 60 women come forward and report, and people still don't believe that anything happened.
While I personally do think Bill Cosby raped some of those women, not all of them, just some of them, I am no one's judge or jury, and it's not up to me. And while it is baffling that 60 people came forward, and there are people who think absolutely nothing happened, it is even more baffling that people to this day believe Mattress Girl, even though the court decided that absolutely nothing happened.
Sometimes the perpetrator even goes so far as to say, I didn't do it. They're lying.
Are you kidding me? Sometimes a perpetrator goes so far as to say, I didn't do it? How is that going too far? Everybody says I didn't do it. Both innocent and guilty people. And this is one of the many reasons why the hashtag Lacey Green raped me started. Because if someone said Lacey Green raped me, her response of course would be, I didn't do it.
This affirms people who don't want to believe that the sexual assault happened. There are a lot of people, particularly in the States, who believe that in order for a rape to be real, you have to have reported it. And in order for that report to be true, court must convict them as guilty.
Well, Lacey, that's how the American justice system works. Innocent until proven guilty. Now, of course, there are some guilty people that can't be proven to be guilty. However, there are just as many, if not more, innocent people who are said to be guilty when they are not.
In reality, about 68% of victims of sexual crimes don't report, and only 2% of rapists ever see a day in jail.
Lacey Green is referring to this graph, which has so much bullshit in it, it's actually hard to figure out where to start. First, let me explain what this entire graph means. The red figures are rapists who have been jailed, the brown figures are rapists who went to trial, the light brown figures are rapists who were reported, the clear brown figures are rapists who are not reported, and the two little black figures at the bottom are people who were falsely accused of rape. First thing you probably noticed is, why are the falsely accused in the non-reported section? You have to be accused in order to be falsely accused. So these two black figures should either be in the reported section or the phase trial section. Second, all the clear brown figures are not reported. The statistic of rapes that are not reported is already bullshit, and we have no clue how many non-reported rapes are true or not. Yes, you can make guesses, but guesses have no place in statistics, so we can take them all out. Now we're down to exactly 100 figures. Now you probably have noticed that only 2% of the figures are black. They're already using the bullshit statistic 2-8% of rape reports are false, but now they're using the lowest percentage possible on top of that. You have got to be kidding me. The very last thing I'm going to bring up is that we can combine the dark brown figures and the light brown figures and call it rape reports that we don't know are true or not. This entire graph is just a whole bunch of bullshit statistics all combined into one. I can't even call this bullshit. It's like bullshit to the fifth power.
Does that mean that 98% of people are just lying? No, it means that our courts aren't arbiters of truth, and they're not always adequately equipped to handle sexual crimes.
I'm pretty sure if you and the other feminists ran a court, you would just throw every single man who was accused of rape in jail.
Then there are myths about how a real victim would act. In reality, there's no one response to sexual assault. Different people handle it in lots of different ways.
I do agree with you mostly on this point, Lacey. However, it's pretty suspicious when someone writes a Tumblr blog and doesn't go to the police.
Another myth when it comes to men is the belief that men can't actually be raped. Men want sex all the time. He had an erection. He was into it. But an erection is not consent.
Well, Lacey, do you know what group started that rumor? It was feminism. You know, the group you're a part of. Also, in countries like Britain, when a woman rapes a man, under the law, it doesn't count. And before you say a woman can't rape a man, watch this scene from Rick and Morty.
Almost. I haven't quite captured your beautiful eyes.
I'm sure it's good enough. Move! Every weekend, Jacks and Roses have their Titanic experience in this car, and I have to mop it up. The floor drops out to make it easier. But now it's my turn. We're going to get it nice and steamy in there. And I'm going to slam my hand on the steam and leave a nice handprint. And then you're going to love inside of me. No mess. No clean.
Beth!
Just so you all know, I did not show that clip to say, haha, this is pure evidence that a woman once tried to rape a man. I showed that clip so I could ask the question, would you count that as rape?
Lastly, one of the sneakiest and I think most pervasive reasons why people don't believe survivors is that most survivors are women.
Bull fucking shit. Women are far more likely to be believed if they have been raped than men. If a man tells people that he has been raped, if he's lucky, he'll be laughed at. If he's unlucky, he'll be the one being thrown into jail. Also, if you include prison rape, men are far more likely to be raped than women.
There are many subconscious sexist beliefs that we learn all throughout our lives that come in and inform our opinions. That women lie a lot, we're not trustworthy, we're manipulative. You know, bitches be crazy.
The media also talks about how women are cleaner than men, how women are more caring than men, how women are kinder than men, and how women are overall better than men. One of the most cliched type of episodes in children's programming is the girl power episode. Also, I think people get the idea of women being liars and manipulators from feminists. I was going to look for an example of a feminist lying and manipulating, but then I realized I don't need to. You have been doing that this entire video.
Those attitudes and biases within ourselves go unchecked. They absolutely do real damage. But wait, what if it really is actually truly, really, truly false? False reports are illegal, and they're typically taken pretty seriously when they surface.
Remember earlier how I brought up Mattress Girl? She was a girl who made one of the biggest false rape allegations of all time. Guess what's happening to her now? She is seriously receiving the award, Woman of Courage. If a woman makes a false rape allegation, if she's really unlucky, she might end up in jail for a year.
Which is why we also need to talk about the reality that sexual assault accounts are nearly always true.
No!
How we more readily believe someone who says they've been robbed than they've been raped.
Well, one is more easier to prove than the other.
How men are far more likely to be sexually assaulted than to be falsely accused.
This might surprise you, Lacey, but some people would rather be sexually assaulted than falsely accused of rape. If a man is sexually assaulted and tries to report it, he'll be laughed at. But if a man is falsely accused of rape, his entire life is destroyed.
If false reports are something that worries you, know that statistically, you're on the side of reason and justice and truth to believe someone who comes forward.
Wrong!
We need to be willing to face the truth, to approach justice honestly, even when the perpetrator is someone that we know and love. So to April Fletcher and any survivor who finds the strength to come forward on YouTube or beyond, I believe you.
And that's the second reason on how the joke Lacey Green raped me started. Throughout this entire video, Lacey Green has been using the word perpetrator and victim, not accused and accuser. Once again, trying to manipulate people. Before I end this video off, I just want to play this clip from Star Trek The Next Generation. I really think it sums this entire thing up.
Tarsus has all but done the same.
How?
He refused to answer the question about his Romulan grandfather.
That is not a crime, Worf. Nor can we infer his guilt because he didn't respond.
Sir, if a man were not afraid of the truth, he would answer.
Oh, no. We cannot allow ourselves to think that.
Sir, the Federation does have enemies. We must seek them out.
Oh, yes. That's how it starts. But the road from legitimate suspicion to rampant paranoia is very much shorter than we think.
My eyes have seen the glory of the cleansing of YouTube, debunking SJWs and feminazis too. We criticize reactionists in hopes they get the boot. Just a robot marches on.